evaluation about what resources we have available in the city to accomplish these goals that met many, many times since then at an apartmental level, at a functional level, at a council level, again, just continuing to refine the plan. You will see as we go through this that, in fact, we have been working this plan since March. Things have actually happened, which is always kind of exciting whenever you've got a strategic plan to see that you're actually going to be implementing it. So today I wanted to tell you a little bit about it, sort of a very high level, because you will see this plan reflected in our 2012 and going forward budget, that the resources that we are going to need in 2012 to accomplish these very ambitious goals will be part of our budget discussions that we're going to be having starting next week, I think. So our public discussions, we've been having lots of private discussions about our budget. So our roadmap for growth, and that's the whole purpose of everything that we are doing here in the city now, is building, is dealing with these pillars: infrastructure, communications, rural outreach, affordable housing, economic development, downtown hub, environment, culture, heritage, and recreation. For those keeners who attended the State of the City address, those were the same topics that we dealt with then. And again, in anticipation that we would be working through this plan. So the first one, infrastructure, which is the bandwagon that we have been, or the drum that we have been beating in our bend for many, many months, probably very shortly since the election. We talked a lot last budget about building a sign on the highway that said, "Brandon, turn there." What we really need to do as a city is, in fact, build to the highway so that it's obvious that Brandon is here. We've all driven into Regina, into Saskatoon, and you know you're at that city because the development is there. That's what we're going to be doing. City Works, which is, we've been talking about sort of asset management and knowing about what's happening under the ground. This critical piece of information and technology is now integrated into how we're dealing with infrastructure in the city. North Hill sewer servicing, and again, I think I remember saying how surprised I was I would spend so much of my time now as the mayor of this city waxing poetic about sewer, but here you go. That again, it was a critical failure during our high water event. The reason why people couldn't return home, just the same way we're raising the dikes and doing the buff and polish in anticipation, we are going to fix this. Diking upgrades, again, has been at the last couple of council meetings. Stormwater drainage plan, and again, no one in Brandon in the last couple of summers is unaware of what happens when we get an intense amount of rain in a short period of time and the streets flood a lot, basements flood a lot. So we are going to put a plan into place that deals with stormwater drainage. Elimination of combined sewers is an element of that. And the gray water recovery strategy, we put an awful lot of gray water, again, not toilet water, but when you turn on the tap and you run the tap so it gets good and cold and all that water goes into the sewer system, that's gray water. We can be reutilizing that water. The water that we have on the stove that we're boiling eggs in, again, we can reclaim that water for whether it's, I don't know, watering the lawn or a variety of other purposes, because that will expand our capacity as well through our wastewater treatment. Communications is the next critical plank, and you've been seeing a lot of this already. Our website upgrades, a communication strategy, which includes a communications director, and a lot of branding and logoing is going to be happening so that our identity as a community, you can see, again, through the little icons that we're starting to begin to incorporate into a lot of our communications. Rural outreach. Brandon is the center of Western Manitoba. In fact, I go out to say that we're the capital of the rest of Manitoba, and we need to step up and take that responsibility on. Regionalization and shared services. There's a lot of opportunities there in terms of economic opportunities and expense rationalization that we can do when we work in partnership with our rural neighbors. Elton, Cornwallis, and Brandon annexation strategy. Right after the election, we took annexation off the table until we can get our collective act together moving forward. There's no sense fighting like cats and dogs about the growth of this city. It is inevitable that we are going to grow, so let's work cooperatively so that the needs of Elton, Cornwallis, and Brandon are met. And again, just recently, the AMM convention, but also rural municipalities as well, meet on a regular quarterly and semi-annual basis. We need to be a larger player there. Again, it's a natural role for the city that has, it's time to reactivate it. Critical to Brandon is affordable housing, that we need a simple definition about what is affordable, and that we can then begin to move forward on our own strategy. 350 units of affordable housing, and again, a drop in the bucket, dare I say, and as we are dealing with anticipated growth, we have got to get a handle on what affordable housing is and what it means to the city. One of the elements we're incorporating into our strategy is a housing first, which means that any city-owned lands, the first question we ask is there an affordable housing use for this land? And inclusionary zoning bylaw as well, to say that if there is a development that comes forward, they have to include affordable housing as part of that strategy. They can perhaps contribute towards an affordable housing pool. They can actually use part of their residential development as affordable housing. Again, we can't continue to only build houses for people who can afford to pay market prices, because that eliminates so many people in our community that can't. Secondary suite bylaw, again, looking at not only existing secondary suites and bringing those up to code, but building capacity within the community to expand. Developer government strategy, because again, if we don't have our government and our developers at the table as we move forward this affordable housing strategy, it's not going to work. And this isn't a top-down change. This very much has got to be built with a community coming together around the table. The bylaw that was passed on Monday, derelict building strategy, we have too many properties in this city that are a blight in their neighborhoods, that it's impacting their adjacent neighbors, it's impacting the community and how their larger neighborhood feels about itself, it's decreasing property values, and again, it's occupying a piece of property that we need to incorporate into our housing strategy. And again, infill opportunities, because we have a lot of opportunities. Even on 14th Street, I was walking down to Clancy's and past 7 lots that are sitting empty. And when we're talking about a desperate need for housing in this city, and that's vacant land, it's a real shame. Economic development. We've talked a lot about projects that are near and dear to my house, heart, but nothing is going to happen without a strong base of economic development. Part of that is we're continuing to move forward as we consider whether the city will bid on the 2017 Games. Again, that bidding process won't start until January, so we're still at the considering stage. The accommodation tax strategy, and I think I'm actually going to arbitrarily say we're not going to call it a tax anymore. This is now an accommodation levy, because, again, tax has got some negative connotations in it, but we've got a good plan now going forward. We'll begin to bring that bylaw back. We're incorporating anticipated revenue in the 2012 budget. Just a very basic comprehensive economic development strategies. We have all the pieces we need. We need to put a big bow around them, and so that we can begin to get that message out again in a comprehensive way. The airport and an air service into Brandon is so critical. It is something that we have been working on relentlessly since the 27th of October, 2010, and it's gonna take a lot longer before we can see progress on this file. Highway 10 lobbying, and I'm not talking, and I'm sorry for all of the folks who have property at Clear Lake, I'm not talking about Brandon to the lake. I am talking about Brandon to the American border. That's our transportation corridor. There's some real economic opportunities there to utilize that corridor. It's part of our airport strategy as well, and again, some really interesting opportunities. Something I talk a lot about is building a smart city, and again, we will not be able to do that without partnerships between the post-secondary institutions, our largest smart employer, the RHA, because we need those jobs for our kids. And so that's how we will build the economic base of this community. And tourism strategy. Again, we have incredible assets in this community, but we're not marketing them and utilizing them to the capacity that we need. A downtown hub, and we've again talked a lot about downtown revitalization, and yay, the brown block's down. Pedestrian mall. We got everyone's attention this summer when we closed Rosser Avenue to create a pedestrian mall. Through the early part of fall and early winter, we've met with a lot of the business owners and residents that live downtown to pull together just a dynamite vision for what next summer is going to be downtown. And I'm not going to tell you what it is. Building equivalency standards, again, our heritage and old inventory of building stock have very different building code challenges than new construction. A lot of other communities have figured this out. Brandon's going to need to figure it out too. Renaissance District Secondary Plan, you've seen the beginnings of that. We've had our public consultation, and that has had first reading at City Council and will be the foundation of how we go forward with our downtown revitalization. Entertainment complex options and assembly of appropriate lands. Again, as the proud owner of the building formerly known as the Brandon Inn, this gives us some opportunities to look at a downtown hotel for business purposes. Again, you see the excitement that's happening right now in Winnipeg across the street from MTS Center is their very first downtown hotel. It hasn't been, it's only been using private sector money. There's no public money in it. And again, it took them 25 years to get there. Hopefully we'll be able to move a little quicker. Environment. Again, we've got a very complex sanitation strategy, and that will be coming to council for further discussion very soon. Green space master plan. One of the things that we love about this city and it contributes to the quality of life is our green spaces and building on that. Household hazardous waste strategy, and again, this is something that folks have been asking for, and we're putting the pieces in together that it's going to work. Citywide recycling strategy, and Brandon does a phenomenal job at this, but we're not resting on our laurels. We can do better. Organics and composting. We've had a volunteer program that has been very enthusiastically received, and we want to roll that out to more people. And a green purchasing strategy as well, because again, we are a major consumer of paper and electricity and water and a variety of other consumables, and making sure we're always doing it in a green fashion. Culture and heritage, again, something that you've heard me speak about. We need two cultural festivals. Everybody loves the Lieutenant Governor's Winterfest. Being able to do something in the summertime and building on what's currently offered at Princess Park and for multicultural tourism, celebration, economic development is part of our strategy going forward. A cultural resource center, and again, the Sokol Hall was built by the Polish community who needed a home. And that has been a center for that community for as long as I can remember in Brandon. We have so many other diverse multicultural groups that need a home as well. Brandon Museum, that they've got the beginnings of a permanent home. We've got to now focus the attention on building the collection and marketing and communication and some of those curatorial aspects. But this is a piece that has begun to take steps forward. Sculptures on the street. Again, public art as an expression of who we are as a people and as a community in terms of tourism and economic development and inspiration, and frankly, because it just looks nice. Brandon Arts Council, and this again is a project that's been moving forward in the background during this past year. We've had the Brandon Arts Council launched, and now we're working together with them to find out how we're going to work together as a city and as an arts council. Recreation, again, another one of the strengths of living in this city. The master plan needs to be refreshed. It was built at a time when we were still anticipating expanding the university and the Y at the site of the university. So a lot of stuff has happened since then. We need to bring it up to date and anticipate for future going forward. The golf course strategy, again, one of the assets that the city owns. We want to make sure that we're good stewards of that asset, and we've got a lot of exciting opportunities coming forward that you'll hear about in the near future. And we will be doing that in an open and transparent way in consultation with the golfing community because it's their golf course. Veterans Way Recreation Plan. When you last saw the Veterans Way project, it was a housing development, and it's not going to be that anymore. There's nothing like a 350-year flood to remind you that you don't build in a floodplain. That we have a lot of needs in our recreation community, and this is great land and a great location for that. We've been working with stakeholders, soccer, football, cricket, keep throwing that cricket out there, to again see how we can build something that they're going to be able to use, both for now and in the future. And one of the things that Brandon lost that we are going to regain is a standalone recreation department, because again, we got a lot of assets tied up in this area, a lot of resources in terms of people, and we want to be able to put a focus on recreation that sometimes doesn't happen because it's part of a larger department. Community centers, and again, we put some funding into place this year to help with managing the ice. These are the centers of so many neighborhoods. The character of the neighborhoods changed over time. People moved away, but people are moving back with young families, and we need to revitalize our community centers. School facilities, and we're working very closely with the school division on how we can have some joint use on those facilities. Those are community-funded institutions, and again, how do we access them? Relocating the skating oval, which has just about finished. Rod, yes? Yes, all done. So again, it's got a new home a little further away from the river, and again, it's going to be beautiful. I can hardly wait. Closed walkways, back path loops, bike path loops. We have an incredible and envious circuit of bike paths, walking paths around the city. We need the, now, if you want to think of that as the rim, we need to do the hub and the spoke so that there is some place to go besides around and around, and we need to close it off. A big piece of that actually was even getting that last stretch of Highway 10 paved near the theater because, again, a lot of folks are biking on gravel, always dangerous, especially in high traffic. All of those initiatives are the things that the people of Brandon will get to see and benefit from and enjoy, but there's some stuff that has to happen in the background that also has to be part of our strategic plan, the enabling pieces. And so that when you look at overhauling our budget process, again, last year, 2 days before we debated the budget, we had a little gathering here at City Hall, and again, there was very limited opportunity for consultation and community engagement. We're revamping that process and going to continue to revamp that process, because at the end of the day, we understand that we are spending your money and the taxpayers' money of Brandon. And so we want to make sure we're spending it in the areas that they want it spent. Employee relations strategy, pay admin review, these are all things that you've maybe seen coming to council, performance management, organizational sustainability, critical hires. We've got several key functions that we've never had before now in place to build our bench strength so we can accomplish some of those previous roadmap objectives. Permanent facilities for the Arabian Horse Show, Brown Block demolition, the Brandon Inn. Long-term funding for our Riverbank Corridor, again, another one of those key jewels in our community that we need to make some significant investments in. And that's it for this. What we're going to be doing, as I said, is these projects are spread out over several years, so they're all not going to happen this year. They are going to be showing up in our 2012 budget, so that it's important that we have this consultation with the community about some of the key objectives that this council is going to be driving forward. And I am very excited to have such a transparent plan in front of the people of Brandon. It will be on the website as elements of the project are either launched or concluded. They'll be branded and logoed so that people can see progress. That accountability will be there so that when we talk about, yeah, sure, you said you were going to do 350 units, so how many did you do? We'll be able to say we did 253 and here's why. We didn't make 350, or in fact we did 472. So again, there will be that transparency, accountability, and working together as a community to grow the community to be the city that we all want to live in.